Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj. Please allow me to announce this broadcast first.
Okay.
Hare Krishna, 各位尊敬的 Vaishnava 奉献者, 服务源于聆听, 今天是 2021年 4月6日, 星期二, 我们荣幸地邀请到的 Bhaktivedanta Vinayaka Singha Swami Maharaj, 继续我们为我们讲述 大国家瓦坛纲目的课程，敬请聆听 ，Hare Krishna。
Thank you, Guru Mani. So we can begin. Guru Mani, so I can begin now.
Krishna, Guru Mani Madaji, 您那儿卖又重新开一下吧，关麦了。好。Hare
Krishna Maharaj, we can begin now.
Okay. Om Jnanatmarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksuran Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha kripasindubhayevacha patitanam pavan ebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about the travels of a cowherd boy from Govardhan, how by the power of a mantra given to him by his guru, he was able to go to the spiritual world.
我们一直在聆听的是哥尔丹山的一位牧牛童，他的故事，他的历程，他的guru给了他一首 mantra，他念着这首 mantra，旅行到了灵性世界。So
he visited different places in the spiritual world, and finally he came to Goloka Vrindavan.
拜访了灵性世界的不同地方。
And he met with Lord Krishna and Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda and all the cowherd boys, and he saw how Lord Krishna would go off to the forest every day.
他在那里，他遇见了主 Krishna, Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda Mama. 还有牧牛童，他目睹了 Krishna 每天都会去森林放牧。So
it was described how Lord Krishna was going off to the forest in the morning, and Nanda Maharaj was following Krishna into the forest. He didn't want to go back. He didn't want to leave Krishna.
Krishna 每天早晨都会从家里去森林，去跟牧牛童们一起去放牛。他的父亲 Nanda Maharaj 也跟随着他一起往森林那边走。他并不想回家，不想离开 Krishna。
So Nanda Maharaj came into the forest with Lord Krishna, and he saw in the forest many auspicious signs. He saw all the different animals in the forest there, how they were all very happy to see Lord Krishna come into the forest.
Nanda Maharaj 就跟随着 Krishna 一起进入了森林，在那里他见到了很多吉祥的征兆。森林当中的很多动物们，他们见到 Krishna 都感到非常快乐。
Yeah, the animals in the forest are creatures like the deer and all the different birds. They were all happy to see Krishna come into their forest.
森林当中的鹿儿、鸟儿们，他们见到 Krishna 进入了森林，都满心欢喜。
So Nanda Maharaj was following Krishna and Balaram, and at a certain point he had to separate from them. He understood it was time for him to go back.
Nanda Maharaj 就跟随着 Krishna Balarama 一起进入森林，在某一时刻呢，他明白到这个时刻他必须要跟 Krishna 和 Balarama 分离回家了。
So Nanda Maharaj smelled their heads and he shed tears of love for Krishna and Balaram.
Nanda Maharaj 就用笔一次嗅着 Krishna Balarama 的头，眼中流出了爱的泪水。
Krishna bowed down to Nanda Maharaj and then told Nanda Maharaj he has to go home because he has many duties to perform.
Krishna 就向 Nanda Maharaj 致以顶拜，并且告诉父亲他必须要回家了，因为还有许多职责等着他要去履行。
Because Lord Krishna knows if Nanda Maharaj doesn't go home, then all the other people in the village of Vrindavan, they will all be lamenting the separation from Krishna.
Krishna 深知，如果 Nanda Maharaj 不回家的话，那么村子里的别的人都会因为跟 Krishna 的分离而感到悲伤。
And Nanda Maharaj has to arrange for Krishna's reception when he comes home in the evening, because they will have a festival for Krishna returning home every evening, and they decorate the village.
Nanda Maharaj 还要安排，等每天傍晚的时候 ，Krishna 从森林回到村子，他要安排这个迎接的仪式。每天呢都会有一个庆典来欢迎他们回家，要点缀整个村庄。
So Krishna and Balaram went deep into the forest, and Nanda Maharaj returned back to go back to the village.
Krishna 和 Balarama 就走进了森林深处， Nanda Maharaj 返回了村子。
Although Nanda Maharaj could not see them, he could hear the sound of the cows, because they were taking the cows with them. So they could hear the cows and they could hear the horns being blown.
Nanda Maharaj 虽然见不到 Krishna Balarama, 但是能听见母牛的哞叫声，因为 Krishna 和 Balarama 带领着母牛们进入森林，他还能听见号角声。
But Nanda Maharaj arranged for some servants to be messengers to bring news to tell them what Krishna was doing.
Nanda 大军还安排了一些仆人，就在也跟着他们一起进入森林，这样可以时不时的给他们传来 Krishna 和 Balarama 在那里的活动的消息。
So then Nanda Maharaj brought the gopis and Mother Yashoda and he took them back to their home. because they were all following Krishna into the forest. So Nanda Maharaj takes them back home.
Nanda Maharaj 带领着牧牛姑娘雅舍的妈妈就回家了，因为这些牧牛姑娘和雅舍的妈妈也都跟随着Krishna进入了森林。
So the gopis enter the village and they begin singing all the pastimes about Lord Krishna, and they're absorbed in the thought of Lord Krishna's company.
他们就回到了村子，唱诵着Krishna的消时光，他们一心一意地想着跟与Krishna作伴的时光。
The gopis are always singing about their pastimes. They sing about the rasa dance, which they do with Krishna, and they sing about the other pastimes which they have with Krishna.
歌唱着Krishna的消时光，歌唱着与Krishna在一起的Rasa之舞，还歌唱着其他跟Krishna在一起的逍遥。
They sing about Lord Krishna playing his flute, how when he plays on his flute, he fills the flute with nectar.
歌唳们就歌颂着Krishna吹奏着笛子的情景，他用甘露
So when Krishna plays on his flute, the demigods, the demigoddesses are traveling in the sky with their husbands. The wives of the demigods are traveling with their husbands in the sky. They all become amazed when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute.
天上的女半神们和他们的丈夫就一起在天空翱翔，当他们听到Krishna的笛音，感到异常的惊讶。And
they become embarrassed. The demigoddesses become embarrassed because they become lusty hearing Krishna play the flute.
这些女半神们就感到很难为情，因为他们一听到Krishna的笛音就 内心涌起了色欲。
So this is all being described. You see, there's this one, the cowherd boy. The cowherd boy from Govardhan, his name is Sarupa, and he's describing about this. He's describing all about Krishna's pastimes to this other person, who's a Brahmana from Mathura.
Krishna的一位牧牛同朋友Sarupa就像来自Mathura的一个一位婆罗门描述着这个情节。So
he's saying it's impossible to fully describe all of Krishna's pastimes.
他说的，不可能详细的一一描述 Krishna 无限的消时光。Because
the Brahman from Mathura would want to hear about Krishna. He want to hear about what Krishna is doing every day. From the moment he wakes up until he returns home in the evening. He would like to hear about all of Krishna's activities. But the cowherd boy, Sarupa, says it's not possible to describe everything.
You'd
have to be like Ananta Shesha. Ananta Shesha has many hoods, and in each of the hoods they can describe all of Krishna's pastimes.
必须得像Ananta Shesha 一样，那身上有许许多的头棚，每一个头棚都在形容着 Krishna 的消失光。
So, you know, the Brahmana, he may say, well, you know, the Sarupa is a great devotee, so he should be able to do anything. He should be able to do this. He should be able to tell about Krishna's pastimes. But Sarupa will say, no, I can't, because the pastimes are so unlimited, they're infinite. So then the Brahmana would say, well, just describe some part of them, and just describe a part of them. Let me hear something.
婆罗门就会说, 那你就描述一部分好了, 至少描述一部分消失光, 让我听一听。
But the cowherd boy says no. He said, it's better not to speak something if it's going to create unhappiness for people.
但是这位牧牛童就会回答说, 不, 如果会给别人
Even Sukadeva Goswami, when he's speaking Srimad Bhagavatam, he does not speak much about the Brijbasi's feelings of separation from Krishna.
即便当 Sukadeva Goswami 描述, 在讲述圣典国家瓦坛的时候，他也没有提到那些 Brijbasi 跟 Krishna 分离的感受。So
Krishna is going into the forest with Balaram, and he sent the gopis and he sent Nanda Maharaj back. So Krishna was feeling pain in his heart, because he had to send the gopis back.
Krishna 和 Balarama 一起走进森林之际, 他必须得把那些牧牛姑娘和南大大军把他们让他们回家。 此时此刻呢, 他内心感到非常的痛苦, 因为他不得不让他们回家。
But the cowherd boys, they quickly pulled Krishna to show him the beauty of the Vrindavan forest and help him to forget about the gopis for a little while. So, hearing about the beauty of Vrindavan forests and seeing the beauty of all the trees and everything, so Krishna was able to tolerate the pain of separation from the gopis.
听到这个温达文森林的美丽，见到了这些美景树木们， Krishna 就能够容忍，就能够忍受。
Krishna feels more pain than the gopis feel. The pain is greater for Krishna being away from the gopis. It was only the cowherd boys who were able to get Krishna to come away, to leave the gopis.
只有牧牛童们才能够让 Krishna 能够离开牧牛姑娘们。
The cowherd boys brought Krishna into the forest, into the very deep dark forest where even the gopis wouldn't be able to go. It would be too scary, too frightening for the gopis to go there.
牧牛童们 就是让使得 Krishna 跟他们一起进入到了浓密的黑暗的森林深处， 在那个地方，那些牧牛姑娘是不敢进入的。
So when Krishna gets into the forest of Vrindavan, then he appreciates the beauty of the forest and he glorifies all the wonderful trees there.
当 Krishna 和牧牛童们进入到森林的时候，他们就欣赏着森林的美景，荣耀着那里的树木们。
And Lord Krishna describes to Balaram, he said, just see, these trees are worshipping you. They're bowing, they're offering their fruits and flowers to your lotus feet.
Krishna 就对 Balarama 说道，看啊，这些树木们正在荣耀你呢，他们正在把他们的水果和鲜花供奉给你的莲花族。
And in this way, they get rid of the ignorance which has caused their birth as trees.
以这种方式，他们就能够去除掉使他们投生为树木的愚昧。
So Krishna's moving in the forest with all the cowherd boys, enjoying the beauty of the forest.And all the moving and non-moving living entities, they're happy to be with Krishna.
Krishna 和所有的牧牛童们就这样进入了森林，享受着森林之美。森林当中所有一切动和不动的生物，因为与 Krishna 待在一起，感到非常的快乐。
He would bring the cows around Govardhan Hill and he would allow the cows to drink the water from the Yamuna. And then as it came to evening, then he would go back to the village, bring all the cows and everything, they all go back to the village.
晚之际呢，他们就会带着所有这些母牛们回到村子。
In the evening, he will enjoy pastimes with the gopis.
在晚上，他会享受跟勾皮们、母牛姑娘们的逍遥时光。
So, the cowherd boy describes the sarupa, the cowherd boy, he's saying that the greatest ecstasy and happiness comes from living in Goloka Vrindavan.
这位牧牛童 sarupa 说道，最伟大的快乐就是居住在 Goloka Vrindavan.
There's nothing which can compare to the happiness and the pleasure which is there in Goloka Vrindavan.
没有什么能比得上在 Goloka Vrindavan 在那里的快乐和幸福感。
So, the people in Vaikuntha, they have a happiness greater.Than the liberated souls.
In Vaikuntha, 上面的人们，他们享受到的快乐是高于那些解脱的灵魂所感受到的快乐。
But there are souls who live in places like Ayodhya and Dwarka, and their happiness is even greater than the people of Vaikuntha.
而那些在阿尤迪亚和多尔卡这样的地方上面的居民感受到的快乐又高于外昆塔的居民感受到的快乐。
Yeah, we heard about that when Gop Kumar went there to Ayodhya and Dwarka.
当 Gop Kumar 去阿尤迪亚、多尔卡的时候，我们也听到了这些事情。
There's some special intimacy which the devotees get there in Ayodhya and in Dwarka, which is not there in Vaikuntha.
在 Ayodhya 和 Dwarka 上面的居民，他们和主的关系，有一种特殊的亲密感。这种亲密感是 Vaikuntha 的居民感受不到的。
The devotees in Ayodhya, they're personal servants to the Supreme Lord, Lord Rama.
Ayodhya 的奉献者们是主 Rama 的私人的仆人。
And in Dwarka, the devotees are able to be friends. They enjoy being friends with Krishna, which is even more intimate than being Krishna's servant.
而在 Dwarka 的奉献者们能够成为 Krishna 的朋友，而这种朋友关系要比仆人关系更加亲密。
But the happiness of the people in Goloka is greater than any of this.
但是在 Goloka 上面的快乐要比其他的地方的快乐更加伟大。
Only those who live in Goloka are able to experience this happiness.
只有居住在 Goloka 上面的奉献者们才能够体验到这种快乐。
Because it's in Goloka, Krishna has the most love, the greatest friendly dealings with his devotees.
因为只有在 Goloka, Krishna 和他的奉献者才能拥有那一种的爱和友情。
So the eternal associates from Vaikuntha, the eternal associates of Krishna from Vaikuntha are incarnations of the Goloka devotees.
麦昆特的永恒同游们是 Goloka 奉献者们的化身。
But the demigods, the devotees who appear on earth, they come to take the pleasure of Lord Vishnu.To enjoy his pastimes.
但是来到地球上的奉献者们，他们是来享受主威士努的消时光带来的快乐。
Just like the demigods, they also come down from the higher planet sometimes to take part in the Lord's pastimes.
就像半神人们。他们是来自高等星宿，他们是来参与主的逍遥时光。
Just like when Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago, some of the different devotees who came and Krishna's pastimes, sometimes we say that they are demigods who came to take part in Krishna's pastimes.
正像主 Krishna 5000年前显现的时候，有不同的奉献者会参与他的逍遥时光。有些是半神人来参与 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
Just like Nanda Maharaj, we say Nanda Maharaj, he's said to be an avatar of the Vasu named Drona.
就像 Nanda Maharaj.我们说 Nanda Maharaj 是一位名叫 Drona 的 Vasu, 他的化身。
Right, there are 8 Vasus, right? One of them is called Drona. So it said Drona, the Vasu named Drona, he became Nanda Maharaj in Krishna Lila.
一共有八位 Vasu, 其中有一位 Vasu 的名字叫 Drona. Drona 就在主 Krishna 的逍遥时光当中呢，就成为了 Nanda Maharaj。
So, we may not understand this, but if we we should understand this correctly. We should understand that the Brijvasi people are all eternal associates of Krishna. So if we think that Nanda Maharaj is just an incarnation of a demigod, it's not really correct. We have to understand that demigods like Drona, he is a partial expansion of the original Brijvasis from the spiritual world.
要明白，像Drona这样的半神，他们只是灵性世界最原始的、最原初的Brijvasi的部分扩展。
And these Brijvasi people, they always accompany Krishna when Krishna comes to the earth.
这些Brijvasi居民们，每当Krishna降临地球的时候，就会陪伴着Krishna一同降临地球。So
Nanda Maharaj is originally from the spiritual world.
因此，Nanda Maharaj是原本来自灵性世界的。From
Goloka Vrindavan.
来自Goloka Vrindavan.
But what happens is, first of all, Nanda Maharaj and the other devotees in Goloka, they first of all expand as avatars in Vaikuntha.
像Nanda Maharaj和别的奉献者。 他们是首先从Goloka扩展成为了Vaikuntha的，在Vaikuntha成为了化身。
Right, and they become associates of Lord Narayan in Vaikuntha.
他们首先是成为了Vaikuntha的Narayan的同游。
Just like Krishna can expand himself, Nanda Maharaj and the different devotees, they can also expand themselves.
正如主 Krishna 可以扩展自己，同样 Nanda Maharaj 和其他的奉献者也可以扩展自身。So
the devotees they enjoy pastimes both in Goloka and in Vaikuntha.
因此，奉献者们他们既可以在 Goloka 享受消时光，也可以在 Vaikuntha 享受消时光。So
it's not correct to say that the associates of Narayan are avatars.
所以说，Narayan的同游们是化身，这种说法是不正确的。Because
we may think that they are not eternal, but actually they are eternal.
因为如果这样一说的话， 好像他们就不是永恒的一样，但事实上，他们全部都是永恒的。So
the associates of Lord Narayan, they come from Goloka Vrindavan into Vaikuntha, and then from Vaikuntha, then they expand again into the material world to become demigods.
因此。 主Narayan的同游们，他们是Goloka Vrindavan的奉献者，他们首先扩展来到了Vaikuntha，之后他们又从Vaikuntha扩展自己，来到了物质世界，成为了半神人们。So
generally, when we think of demigods, we think demigods are conditioned souls.
一般。 每当我们想到半神人的时候，就认为他们是受条件限制的灵魂。
But these demigods are These are special demigods. They're empowered representatives of Krishna.
但这一些特殊的半神人们，他们是 Krishna 被授予权力的代表。
So, Sarupa, this cowherd boy from Govardhan, who's with Krishna, he's going to describe the incarnations of the Goloka, of the inhabitants of Goloka.
Sarupa, 这位在 Govardhan 山的牧牛童，他和 Krishna 在一起，他接下来要描述 Goloka 的那些化身们。
Just as Krishna has incarnations, so the Goloka, the people of Goloka also have incarnations.
就像主 Krishna 有化身，所以 Goloka 的人们他们也有各自的化身。
So Krishna's avatars are not different from him.
Krishna 的化身是跟 Krishna 没有区别。
And so the same way the associates of Krishna are not different from the original people of Goloka.
同样的 ,Krishna 的这些同游们的化身跟在原本的 Goloka 的那些人们是没有区别的。
So the associates of the Lord in Vaikuntha, who they expand from Goloka.
So, Vaikuntha 的这些同游们，主的同游们，他们是 Goloka 的那些人们的扩展。
Yeah, they're like a reflection of the people of Goloka, Vrindavan.
他们就好比 Goloka Vrindavan 的人们居民们的反射。
And then they expand again as demigods. So the demigods are like shadows.
接下来他们又扩展自己为半神人，这些半神人们就好比是原本的那些居民们的影子。
So both the reflection and a shadow, they follow the person as expansions.
所以这些倒影和这些反射和影子，他们都是原初的那些人们的扩展。
But the shadow doesn't show so much as the reflection. The reflection will show more qualities, but the shadow doesn't show so much.
比起那些反射的来说，这些影子们他们展示出的品质并不如那些反射他们展示出的品质多。
So if we say Nanda Maharaj, when he appears on earth, is an avatar of Drona, then it's only because both Nanda Maharaj and Drona are avatars of Nanda Maharaj in Goloka.
我们说当我们说 Nanda Maharaj 是 Drona 的一个化身的时候，这个意思就是说 Drona 和 Nanda 他们都是最原初的 Goloka Vrindavan 的 Nanda Maharaj 的扩展。
Nanda Maharaj on earth is the same as Nanda Maharaj in Goloka.
地球上的 Nanda Maharaj 和 Goloka 上面的 Nanda Maharaj 是一个人。
Drona is only a partial expansion.
Drona 它只是部分扩展。
But because he's a demigod, demigods are considered superior to humans.
但是因为他是一位半神人，所以半神人被认为是高于人类的。
So Nanda Maharaj is considered Drona's incarnation.
因此 Nanda Maharaj 被认为是 Drona 的化身。
So demigods like Drona They come to earth to take part in the Lord's pastimes.
半神人们，他们也降临来参与主的消时光。
Now, Lord Vishnu's incarnations, they appear only for a short time in the material world.
主 Vishnu 的化身们只是在物质世界，存在短暂的时间。
And sometimes, and they will appear again. They will come, and then they will go, and then they will come again. So they repeat, they appear periodically.
他们会来降临，然后又离开，之后又再次降临显现，所以他们的显现是阶段性的。
So the same way Krishna's associates, they will manifest some as demigods, and then they will become, they will appear on earth as avatars.
同样，主 Krishna 的同游，他们会展示为半神人，接着呢，他们又会以化身的形式来到降临地球。
Just like Nanda Maharaj is the eternal father of Lord Krishna in Goloka.
就像 Nanda Maharaj 是 Krishna 在 Goloka 的永恒的父亲。
But he also appears in Vaikuntha.As the eternal associate of Narayan, called Nanda.
但是他也在百昆塔显现为主 Narayan 的永恒同游，名字是 Nanda.
And sometimes he also comes to the earth in his original identity as Krishna's father.
有时候他也。以他最原初的身份降临地球，作为 Krishna 的父亲。
So in the same way, Lord Balaram, he also resides in Goloka, and then he will manifest himself in Vaikuntha as an associate of Narayan. That time he'll be known as Shesha.So Lord Balaram is in Goloka, but then in Vaikuntha he comes as Shesha.
同样，主 Balarama 是居住在永恒的居住在 Goloka， 但是他在 Vaikuntha， 他也以 Shesha 的身份成为主 Narayan 的同游。所以在Goloka 他是 Balaram， 而在 Vaikuntha 他就是 Shesha。
And then he will appear in the demigods. Among the demigods, he will appear as the one who bears up the earth, who picks up the earth.
在半神人当中呢，他又显现为一位举起了地球的人。
And sometimes he will come to earth as Krishna's big brother, Balaram.
有时候他又降临地球，显现为 Krishna 的哥哥 Balaram。
And Krishna's friend Sridham in Goloka, he comes as Garuda.
在 Goloka, Krishna 的朋友 Sridham, 他又以 Garuda 的身份显现。
And he will come as an associate of the Lord in Vaikuntha.He will come in two forms, right? Sridham will come in two forms. One is as an eternal associate of the Lord in Vaikuntha.
So, Sridham, he will come in two forms. One is as in Vaikuntha, as a Narayan's eternal companion.
And the other way, he will come as the son of.Vinata among the demigods.
而另外一种显现方式是在半神人当中，他显现为一位半神的儿子 ，Vinata 的儿子。
And sometimes he will appear on earth as Sridham, the cowherd boy. Krishna's friend.
还有些时候，他会以 Krishna 的朋友 Shridam 的一位牧牛童的身份降临，显现在地球上。
And then also Krishna's parents in Goloka, in Goloka, Krishna's parents are Vasudeva and Devaki, but they appear as Sutapa and Prishni in Vaikuntha.
在 Goloka, Krishna 永恒的父母 Vasudeva 和 Devaki, 他们在地球上，他们显现为Sutapa和 Prishni.
And Kashyapa and Aditi, they will be Krishna's parents in Swarga, in the heavenly planets.
Krishna 的父母 Kashyapa 和 Aditi, 他们会显现在 Swarga Loka, 天堂。
And sometimes Vasudeva and Devaki will come on earth, they will appear in earth as in their original form as the mother and father of Lord Krishna.
有时候 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 他们就降临在地球上，以他们最原始的 Krishna 的父母的形象来显现在地球。
So it's like that with all of Krishna's different devotees.They have their different incarnations.
Krishna 不同的奉献者们就是这样，他们都有不同的化身。
So just as Krishna is non-different from his incarnations, in the same way the people of Goloka are not different from their incarnations.
正如主 Krishna 与他的化身没有区别。同样 ，Goloka 的人们，他们也和他们自己的化身没有区别。
They may change their names and they may appear to be different, but they're still the same person.
他们也许会改头换面，换一个名字，或者以不同的形象显现，但他们是一个人。
Right. Just like the form of Krishna.The form of Krishna is not different, although he expands many different incarnations, but they're all Krishna.
正像 Krishna, 他可以扩展为许许多多的化身，但他们都是 Krishna.
So when Nanda and Yashoda expand in Vaikuntha, they're the same.
同样，当南达和亚修达在百昆塔扩展他们自己的时候，他们是一样的。
Not different from the original form of Goloka.
和 Goloka 上面最原始的形象没有区分。
So the Goloka Vasis are born sometimes as partial expansions and sometimes as their full selves.
Goloka Vasi, 这 Goloka 的居民们，他们有的时候会扩展为部分的化身，有的时候他们又以完整的形象显现自己。
Just like Krishna varies according to the time and the place and the need. So they vary also their appearance.
正如 Krishna 是根据时间、地点和需要，他会有不同的展示。同样，就这些 Goloka Vasi, 他们也会有不同的展示。
Whenever there's a need for a full or a partial incarnation of a devotee, that devotee will appear.
一旦需要这奉献者，或者是全部的 完整的化身或者是部分化身显现的时候，这位奉献者就会以这种形象显现。
Just like in previous ages, Krishna manifested partial forms of himself in this world.
正像在以前的年代， Krishna 在这个世界上就以部分的扩展显现为显现他自己。
In the Satya Yuga, for example, Lord Varaha descended from the Vaikuntha.
在萨提亚年代，主瓦拉哈就从白昆塔降临。
And he picked up the earth from the bottom of the universe.
把地球从宇宙的底部给捡了起来。
Then at the end of the Dwapara Yuga, Lord Krishna appears as the Lord of Mathura.
接着在杜瓦帕尤格就是同期年代主显现为马图拉的主人。
And this time Krishna appears in his full form to display special pastimes with his devotees.
这一次主 Krishna 是以完整的形象展示了自己，他和他的奉献者们上演了特殊的逍遥时光。
So Krishna's companions, according to their mood, they will come with Krishna. They will come in different forms, different times. They will come to take part in Krishna's pastimes. Whenever Krishna comes, they would like to come along with him.
有的时候 ，Krishna 的同游们，他们。就会参与，当 Krishna 来临的时候呢，他们就会一起跟 Krishna 来参与到 Krishna 消时光，他们都会以不同的形象来，以他们各自的心态来。
So sometimes it tells us that devotees who live with Krishna and Goloka, they appear to merge, or they enter into their own forms.
据说在 Goloka 和 Krishna 居住在一起的奉献者们，他们会融入，就是融入进入到自己的形象。
Just like Krishna can have many expansions and they can all merge with him, they can become again one, he can expand himself unlimited numbers of times.
正如Krishna 他可以扩展出许许多多的形象，但是这些形象又可以合并为一个人。同样主 Krishna 的这些同游们也可以扩展出无限的无穷无尽的形象，但又可以合为一个形象。
So the same way expansions of Krishna's associatesThe expansions of Krishna's associates, they descend to become the original associates.
同样的，主 Krishna 同游的扩展，他们也以最原初的同游的身份降临到地球上。
So the expansions merge into the original form.
所以这些扩展们，他们又会融进最原初的形象当中。
Just like in Goloka, Nanda Maharaj serves Krishna as Krishna's father.
比如说，在 Goloka, Nanda Maharaj 他以父亲的身份来服务 Krishna.
So when Krishna plans to go to Earth to display childhood pastimes, Nanda Maharaj also wants to go with him.
当主 Krishna 决定降临地球上演童年的逍遥时光，南达 Maharaj 也决定跟他一起来。
So by Krishna's arrangement, Lord Brahma then arranges for Nanda Maharaj's expansion, the Vasudrona, to attain. He arranges for that Vasudrona to become a perfect devotee for Lord Vishnu.
Krishna 的安排，主 Brahma 他就安排了Nanda Maharaj 的扩展，这位名叫 Drona 的 Vasu， 他成为了主 Vishnu 的完美的奉献者。
Actually, Drona is already an expansion of Krishna's eternal associate.
实际上 ，Drona 他已经是 Krishna 的永恒同游的扩展了。
But on the strength of that blessing, Drona merges into the original form of Nanda Maharaj.
但是由于这份祝福。Drona 他就融进了，他就和与 Nanda Maharaj 的与 Nanda Maharaj 合为一体了。
And then they become part of the entourage to go with Krishna to appear on the Earth planet.
就这样，他们就成为主 Krishna 降临地球时候的，这些随众多随从当中的。
So in the Puranas, they say sometimes, they say Drona becomes Nanda.
在有些往事书 Purana 中说到 Drona 就成为了 Nanda.
So in the Padma Purana, it tells about the previous life of Radharani's previous life.
在莲花往事书 Padma Purana 就讲述了 Radharani 的前世。
Because she's attracted to come from Goloka for the service of Lord Krishna.
在 Goloka, 她受到吸引，来服务Krishna。
So she incarnates in different places. She incarnates in those different births in various forms and places.
所以她就会在不同的地方以化身为不同的形象，就投生。
Okay, so we will stop here.
好，那我们讲课部分就停到这里。接下来我们看一下。好，第一个问题。
Somebody asked me a question. Question. They wanted to know about what happens to the holy Dham at the time of the annihilation of the material world.
有的人就问了 Maharaj 这个问题，就在物质世界毁灭的时候，圣地他们会怎么样？
So you have to understand that just like Lord Krishna can expand himself.The Holy Dham is also an expansion. When the Holy Dham appears in the material world, it's an expansion of from the spiritual world.
要明白，就像主 Krishna 他可以扩展他自己，同样的，圣地也可以扩展自己。所以，圣地他们也是从灵性世界扩展自己，来到了物质世界的。
So when there's an annihilation of the material world, what happens is the holy Dham will go back to the spiritual world.
所以在物质世界毁灭的时候呢，圣地他们就回到返回灵性世界了。
Just like Krishna can expand himself many times.Krishna expands himself many times, so the same way the spiritual world can also expand.
正像 Krishna 可以扩展自己许许多多次，同样的灵性世界也可以扩展自己。
And we were hearing how Lord Krishna, when he expands all the different parts, they can all expand, they can go back into each other.They re-enter each other, they merge, they become one again. So the same way the Holy Dham also becomes one.
So, we in the lecture, we hear Krishna can expand himself. And then, all these Krishna's expansion, they then enter into each other, one and one. Same thing, the holy, their holy expansion.他们也可以合而为一。
嗯。Okay, so what's the question?
好，第一个问题是来自于阿米章 ，Hare Krishna Maharaj, please accept my humble respect and obeisance. All glory to Prabhupada. This is a greeting from 阿米章。Okay, the next one is Yogadharma said horrible obeisance to Gurudev's lotus feet, and Panchidong also pay obeisance to your lotus feet, and Sugita Sangha Mara said, Mataji said, please take care. And okay, there are many.Greetings and good wishes from devotee. Here is the question from Radha Priya. 顶拜孤的莲花族，感谢您的仁慈讲课。南的爸爸是原初 Vrindavan Krishna 父亲的化身。那么这个化身在物质世界上演完消失光后，他回去是融入自己的形象吗？This is first part of the question. Radha Priya paid obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. And thank you for the merciful lecture. Nanda Baba is the incarnation of the original father of Krishna. Then after he finished the Lila in this material world, Will this incarnation merge into his original form?
Yes, right.
是的，是的，他是会融入自己的形象。And she continued to ask, will that also happen to us?
Well, we're not on the level of Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Maharaj is an eternal associate of Lord Krishna.
Nanda Maharaj is 主 Krishna 的永恒同友。
We're trying to become devotees.
我们是在努力。成为奉献者。
Just like among the gopis, there are different kinds of gopis. Some gopis are Nitya Siddha, and some other gopis are Sadhana Siddha.
就像有不同种类的 gopi 牧牛姑娘，有一种呢是 Nitya Siddha 永恒的完美的，还有一种呢是 Sadhana Siddha 是通过各项修行达到完美的。
So.To become sadhana siddha, we have to do practice for a very long time.
要想 就是透过 sadhana siddha 这个方法呢，我们需要休息很长时间。
There are different types of sadhana siddha gopis.
有不同种类的 sadhana siddha gopi.
One group are come there from the personified Vedas.
有一群是通过韦达经的人格化身，这一群。
They want you to understand the person. They want to understand the Lord in his most perfect and his most pleasing feature. They wanted to develop that loving relationship with the Lord.
他们想明白主的最悦人的、最令人愉快的特征。他们希望跟主发展这种爱心的交流。
Because they are the personified Vedas, and from the Vedas, it's very difficult to understand the personality of Godhead.
因为他们是韦达经的人格化身，人要想通过韦达经，很难理解至尊性格神兽。
So they got the blessing that they could take birth in the family of cowherds of Vrindavan.
他们就得到了祝福，可以投生在文达文的牧牛郎之家。
And then from there they could develop their love for Krishna.
从这种情况，他们发展出对 Krishna 的爱。
And then there's another group of gopis. They're from the sages who live in the forest, and they had seen Lord Ramachandra in the previous yuga.
还有一群牧牛姑娘，他们是在前一个年代。居住在森林里的圣人，他们曾经见过主 Ramachandra。
So they were great sages, and they wanted to have a conjugal relationship with Lord Ramachandra.
他们都身为伟大的圣哲们，他们想要和主 Ramachandra 发展出情侣关系。
But Lord Ramachandra told them in this life it would not be possible, because.He'd made a vow only to take one wife.
主 Ramachandra 告诉他们，在这一世是不可能的，因为他已经发誓只娶一位妻子。
But if you come in my next incarnation, when I come as Lord Krishna, at that time you can take birth in the families of cowherd people of Vrindavan.
但是他告诉圣哲们。在我下一个化身以 Krishna 的身份降临的时候，你们可以出生在文达文，成为投生在这些牧牛郎的家庭。
So these sages they came. So there's these two groups of gopis. One is the personified Vedas, and the other is the great sages from the Naimisharanya, from the.Dandakaranya forest.
就这两组 gopi, 一组呢是韦达经的人格化身，还有一组 gopi 呢，他们上一世是 Dandaka, 就是这个Naimisharanya森林当中的圣者们。
不是 Naimisharanya, Dandakaranya.
哦，对不起，是 Dandakaranya森林当中的圣者们。
Mm-hmm. And so both of these groups of gopis are sadhana siddha, and they become perfect by spiritual practice.
So these two gopis, they are sadhana siddha, they are through practicing to become perfect.
So if we want to go back to Godhead, if we want to go to Goloka, you have to develop the mood of these.You know, I have to maybe take a next birth in the families of the cowherd people of Vrindavan.
所以如果我们想回归回到格鲁卡，培养格鲁卡的心态，也许我们需要再投生一次，投在文达文的那些牧牛郎之家投生。
That's how you get trained to enter into Krishna's pastimes.
就以这种方式得到训练，来从而进入 Krishna 的消时光。
But don't worry about it. Krishna will make all arrangements.
但是不要担心， Krishna 会做出安排。
Just continue to hear about Krishna and develop attraction for Krishna.
只需要继续聆听 Krishna， 发展出对 Krishna 被 Krishna 所吸引。
Okay. Are there any other questions?
So the third part of the question, she continued to ask, are we also the expansion of some devotee in the spiritual world?
Well, but yeah, we all have some relationship with Krishna, an eternal relationship with Krishna.
我们都跟主 Krishna有一种永恒的关系。
We don't know what particular rasa we will have with Krishna.
我们不知道我们和 Krishna 会将会有一种什么样的 rasa， 一种什么样的关系。
Generally, we try to follow in the footsteps of these great devotees. We don't think that we are, we don't think we are Krishna, or we don't think we are Radharani or Mother Yashoda, but we want to follow in the footsteps of the example of these devotees.
我们通常是追随这些伟大奉献者的足迹。我们不会想我们是 Krishna， 也不去想我们就是 Radharani， 也不想我们是亚修的。我们是追随这些伟大奉献者的步伐，以他们为榜样。
We want to be the servant, follow in the footsteps of these people of Vrindavan.
我们希望成为仆人。追随 Vrindavan 这些伟大奉献者的足迹。
And different devotees will be attracted to different personalities in Krishna's pastimes.
不同的奉献者就会受到 Krishna 消时光当中不同人物的吸引。
Maybe you're attracted to be like a gopi, to be like Srimati Radharani or the other gopis.
也许你会受到吸引，成为勾皮，成为像 Srimati Radharani 或其他勾皮那样的牧牛姑娘。
Lord Chaitanya and his associates, they all had the mood of the gopis. They cultivated the mood of the gopis.
如 Chaitanya 和他的同游们，他们都有牧牛姑娘的心态，他们都在偷。培养的是牧牛姑娘的心绪。
They were always feeling separation from Krishna. Where is Krishna? When is Krishna coming?
他们都感受着跟 Krishna 的分离。Krishna 在哪里？ Krishna 什么时候来？
But some people are more in the mood of being cowherd boy. They like to be a friend with Krishna.
而有些人，他们更喜欢。拥有牧牛童的心态，想成为 Krishna 的朋友。
And other people may be more in the mood of a parent, like Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda.
还有一些人呢，想要就是成就拥有 Krishna 父母的心态，就像 Nanda Maharaj 和 Yashoda 妈妈那样。
They're always thinking about giving protection to Lord Krishna.Taking care of Krishna.
他们总想着怎么保护 Krishna， 怎么去照顾 Krishna.
So gradually, as we become purified, we will become more attractive to a particular personality, a particular rasa, and we want to be the servant of that person. Not that we think we are that person, but we want to serve, and we want to learn from him or her how to serve Krishna.
逐渐的，我们进化了之后呢，就会受到某个特殊人物的吸引。就会想要发展出那种特定的关系，我们是想要成为那个特殊人物的仆人，而不是成为那个特殊的人物，是想要向这位特殊的人物学习，想要服务他，学习如何去服务 Krishna。
OK。
好，下一个问题。下一个问题是来自于 Shruti Rupa Devadasi， 顶拜 Guru 和老师们，感恩 Guru 精彩的讲课。有两个问题请教 Guru： 一，在我一个阅读国家梵歌和瓦坛的学习群，有新人提出这些知识太灵性了，听起来太陌生了，能不能结合中国传统文化的一些经典故事？一方面调整好大家学习兴趣和心态，一方面慢慢吸收这些超人知识，从而引导大家更好务实的生活和工作。请问 Guru， 这样的学习方法是否是可以被允许的吗？
嗯，
啊 ，basic。
Go ahead. Yeah.
Guru and.Basis to Guru and teachers, thank you for that wonderful lecture. I have two questions. The first one, I have a WeChat group that is reading Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. And some new faculties, they raised the opinion that those knowledge are too spiritual. It sounds not familiar, too a foreigner. They said that can we combine those knowledge with the traditional Chinese culture, the traditional scripture, and the traditional stories in the traditional Chinese culture, so that on the one hand, that everybody interested in learning, and on the other hand, they can gradually absorb those transcendental knowledge, so that everybody can have a practical life and practical work. I want to ask, Guru, is this the method of learning permissioned, permitted? This kind of method of learning?
No. Not really, not encouraged. Because you have to understand, that although this knowledge in the Bhagavad Gita and scriptures may be new to you, that if you hear about it, if you hear it regularly, gradually, it will become more familiar to you.
这种方法是不被鼓励的，没有说不是受到鼓励的。要明白，就是像《薄伽梵歌》这样的经典的知识，虽然听上去很新鲜，但是呢，如果有规律的、定期的聆听的话，逐渐就能熟悉了。
Now, just like you're saying, traditional knowledge, Chinese knowledge, you know, this is traditional.To you, because you've been hearing it, because you've heard it from your childhood, you were brought up hearing it, so you can accept it all. But it's not that everybody knows these things, these traditional Chinese things.
就好像，传统中国传统文化，你们呢从小就耳熟能详了。 就已经受到了灌输聆听了，所以就接受了。但是呢，并不是每个人都知道传统中国的传统文化的。
You have to understand, you're not Chinese. You're a spirit soul. So the knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita is to bring us out of the material concept of life, to bring us to this transcendental platform.
你要明白，你不是中国人，你是灵魂。薄伽梵歌的知识是要把我们带出，让我们离开这个物质的生活概念，把我们带到灵性的层面。
So, if you continue hearing the Chinese knowledge, you will always be in the bodily concept of life. You're never going to get out of the bodily conception of life. And you'll come back again. You'll have to take birth again. Come back again in China.
如果是持续不断的聆听中国的传统文化知识的话，那么就一直处在这种躯体化概念当中，永远摆脱不了这种躯体化的概念，而且还要再次回来投生为中国人。
Hey, you're not going to get free of birth and death with this traditional knowledge.
用这种传统文化不能使人摆脱生死。
So you have to be patient and you have to gradually hear the Bhagavad Gita. Now, just like myself, it was new to me also when I became a devotee, but I just kept hearing. You just continue hearing and gradually, you can start to understand.
你需要有耐心，逐步的聆听，就像我本人。我一开始是新奉献者的时候，这对我来说也是新的，但是不断的聆听，逐渐的就能够明白了。
So, this, the knowledge of the scriptures is actually the real traditional knowledge, the tradition that we're spirit souls, that we're not the body.We want to get that knowledge right.
那实际上呢，这些经典的知识才是真正的传统文化知识，因为在传统上，我们都是灵魂，而不是这个躯体。我们应该有这种知识。
So you please continue gradually hearing.And gradually, you will awaken your spiritual consciousness.
所以请继续逐步的聆听，这样呢就能唤醒灵性的知识了。
Don't be impatient. You have to be patient. It's going to take some time.
不要不耐烦，要有耐心，这需要时间。
All right.
The next question. 有新人问，我近70岁的母亲现在对生活毫无理想，每天是玩抖音、看电视，或者和老年朋友出去玩耍。但是她的思想被过往生活的经历和价值观覆盖，现在已经出现反应迟钝、记忆力衰退等症状，行为孤鲁。如果这时候开始慢慢用圣名和沙等和奉献者联谊影响母亲，是否可以成功阻止他像老年痴呆症发展呢？感恩。I have a friend, who asked me.That she had a mother, who is 17 years old, had no ideal in the life, only indulged in the cell phone games and watching at the cell phone and watching TV or play with old friends. And she was covered by the old, by the life experience, and also by the old concept of life. But now, she's becoming demented, had got the disease of demented. And so she would ask the guru, from now on, can we use the holy name Prasad and the association of devotee to influence the mother and prevent her from to develop further this demented disease?
Yes, very good.
是的, 可以, 非常好。
Use prasadam and the holy name.
用普沙丹和圣名,
that's the right medicine for everyone.
这对每个人来说都是一个万能的良药。
So you please do that.
所以请你这样去做。
Yes.
The next question is from SD. 顶拜古鲁莲花族, 感恩古鲁无限的仁慈, 甜美的甘露, 请问Krishna讲国家梵歌是两臂形体吗? 祝福古鲁早日康复。
两臂形体。
So this devotee SD, she paid us a visit to Guru's lotus feet and thank you for your unlimited mercy and nectar.
Yeah.
She asked, when Krishna speak Bhagavad Gita, is in his two-arm form?
Yes.
是的，是两臂形体。
But then we see Krishna showed the universal form in the 11th chapter. He showed the universal form, and then he showed this four-arm form to Arjuna. And then Arjuna requested Krishna to please come back to his two-arm form.
我们看到就在第十一章的时候，Krishna展示了他的宇宙形体。 随后他又展示了四臂形象，向阿尔朱那展示了四臂形象。接下来，在阿尔朱那的要求恳求下，他恢复了他的两臂形象。
And it was described that the two-arm form was the most dear form, that was the most pleasing form to Arjuna.
据描述 ，Krishna 的两臂形象是。 最亲密的形象，对阿尔朱那来说是 Krishna 最亲密的形象，是最令人愉快的形象。
Yes.
So she wishes Guru to recover, soon.
Okay. Thank you.
The next question from 小女子, 顶拜咕噜, 我刚刚接触风爱瑜伽不久, 发现奉献者中取得物质成功的人不多, 这是什么原因呢? So this new devotee, she asked, a business guru, I have just contact with Bhakti Yoga, but I found that among devotees, there are not so many who had achieved the material success. Well, what's the reason?
Well, what do you think is material success? You're thinking material success is to be very rich, or to be very famous in the material world, or maybe it's to have a very good, a big position in society, to be respected.
那么您认为物质的成功是什么呢？是在物质是非常富有，是在物质世界很有名望，是不是在社会上有地位，受人尊重？
So in the in Srimad Bhagavatam, we have the prayers offered by Queen Kunti, and Queen Kunti describes that if somebody is on the path of material progress, then it's very difficult for them to know Krishna.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛当中有昆提王后的祈祷，昆提王后就形容一个走在物质繁荣道路上的人很难了解 Krishna.
Because when you have these material opulences, then you become blinded and we become very attached to the material things, and we forget that these things are temporary.
一旦人拥有了物质富裕，他就会被这些富裕遮蔽双眼，就变得盲目，他也会依附这些物质的事物，他会忘记这一切都是短暂的。
You have to understand that the real wealth is not measured materially, but the person who is actually wealthy, they have spiritual assets. They have eternal assets, spiritual assets, which are there in the form of spiritual knowledge and detachment from the material.
你要明白，真正的财富，什么是真正的财富？真正的财富是那些灵性的财富，而不是物质的这些财富。真正的财富呢，是灵性知识，以灵性知识形象出现的这个财富，是对物质世界的弃绝，这个是真正的财富。
People who have material assets, they're very proud, and that pride is another kind of ignorance. It covers up one's real spiritual nature.
拥有物质财富，拥有物质财产的人们，他们很骄傲，他们就会被无知覆盖，这种无知会覆盖他们的灵性本性。
So you may think devotees are poor, but you don't know what is the real wealth of a devotee.
您认为奉献者很穷，但是您不知道奉献者的真正的财富是什么。
The real wealth is in their peace of mind and detachment from the material.
真正的财富是心意平和，真正的财富是弃绝物质。
Krishna may give material opulence to people. We shouldn't become proud of these things.
Krishna 可以给予物质的富裕，但是我们不应当为此感到骄傲，沾沾自喜。
A devotee can accept the opulence given by Krishna to use it for Krishna's service.
奉献者们可以接受 Krishna 给予的富裕，把这些富裕拿来服务 Krishna。
But we see that the generally people who have these material opulences, they're very attached to the bodily concept of life, and it's very hard for them to take up Krishna consciousness.
但是我们看到一般拥有物质富裕的人，他们有很重的依附之心，他们很依恋躯体化生命的概念，他们很难接受 Krishna 之觉。
So your observation is correct in some extent. You may say devotees are not very rich, they're not very opulent. It's probably true.
所以您的观察在某种程度上是正确的， 奉献者们并不很富有，并没有很多的富裕，这也很可能是真的。
But you have to see that they have a special wealth that they're not so much concerned about the material things. They have the spiritual wealth.
但是您要看到奉献者们拥有特殊的富裕，他们并不关心物质的事物，他们拥有灵性的富裕。
Okay.
She continued to ask, 我们今生的物质财富、地位、学识、美貌、家庭关系、寿命长短等，随着灵修进步会得以提升吗？ Our material opulence, position, knowledge, education, beauty, family relationship, and our lifespan will be elevated.As our spiritual practice progress.
No, not necessarily.
不一定。
Spiritual practice, as our spiritual practice progresses, we become detached from these things.
随着灵修的进展，我们会变得不依附这些。
So Krishna may give, and Krishna may not.
Krishna 呢可以给我们这些，但是呢 ，Krishna 也可能不给我们这些。
But whatever condition a devotee is in, the devotee will be satisfied.
然而呢？奉献者们，他无论他处于什么样的境况当中，他都是心满意足的。
We see sometimes devotees, some devotees are very rich, and we see some devotees are very poor.
我们看到呢，有的奉献者是很富裕的，而有的奉献者又是很贫穷的。
We should not think that.Material wealth is a measure of their spiritual advancement.
We 不应当以为物质的富裕是灵性进步的一个衡量尺度。
And we shouldn't think that because somebody doesn't have material wealth, that it means they're not advanced.
我们也另一方面不要以为那些没有物质财富的人们，他们在灵修上，他们的灵修就不进步了。
You have to see the heart of the person.
你要需要看到的是这个人的内心。
We see in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya, there were some devotees who were very wealthy, and there were some people who were very poor.
我们在主柴丹尼亚的逍遥时光当中看到，有些奉献者是很富裕的，还有些奉献者又是很贫穷的。
But they were all great devotees.
然而，他们二者都是伟大的奉献者。The next one.
Yeah.
我感觉自己有很。
可以听到我声音吗
？Yeah， 听到。
现在已经1:40了，我们后面还有问题。我想今天我们就先到这里吧，因为我想您还没有完全的这个痊愈，所以我把后面的问题留到下一次课吧。
随便，可以。还有多少问题？
后面还有3-4问题吧。哎呀，还有提上来的，还有陆续提上来的。四个问题，还有四个问题。 我想可能会时间会久，可能到能得到九点钟，时间太长了吧。
OK， 随便。
嗯。
他们的问题等到下一个星期。
好的，好的。对你，我想你还是需要多休息。我们奉献者们也也该理解啊，咕噜还没有痊愈，所以非常仁慈的跟我们讲这个课已经现在持续一个多小时了，所以我们请咕噜休息吧，后面的问题我们下周再请咕噜解答，我们会把问题保留下来的。
好 ，OK。
嗯，非常感谢咕噜马哈扎吉的讲课。
OK， 感谢所有的奉献者聆听。OK， Hare Krishna， 感谢 Guru Mani， 给我们整台的翻译。
好，那 Vaikuntha 之音服务员聆听，非常感谢 Shambhavi Vaidnavanasana Singha Swamara 给我们带来的精彩的讲课，感谢 Sati Mata 的主持，感谢所有奉献者的耐心聆听和提出的好问题，祝大家有一个 Krishna 知觉的一天。 Hare Krishna。
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Jai.